Hi all, this is R. Prentke with another tutorial video from Eyewire. This is one of the practice cubes that comes after the tutorial cubes. So you won't be getting direct feedback while you're working, you'll get some afterwards and you'll also get some points. Let's get started. You may notice that it gets a little bit blurry when I change slices once in a while. That's just caused by the site trying to load it, and it's just taking a moment. Once in a while, you'll also get a checkerboard pattern, and if you just let it sit for a second, it'll fix itself. Alright, so there's something odd going on right here that I'm not entirely sure what's happening. So we're going to come to that later. We're going to wait for it to connect to the big blue thing, though. And that was the checkerboard pattern I was talking earlier. So if I slow down my scrolling through the slices, it should stop doing that. Alright, so we're going to follow this blue one out, this little one. And I'm choosing the smaller one because we're more likely to miss that later if we were to do the other one first. And also I've got a hunch it may end earlier. Let's find out. Alright, so it looks like there. Okay, it looks like it may be going up this direction. So let's take a look at that. Alright, so that looks like it's... Oh, that looks actually like it's wrong. So if I go and look at this again in the 3D, take a look at this. Let me zoom in for you and then drag it to the right by right-clicking. So this blue piece right here, this is what we were following, this dark blue one. And what should be added is something coming off of here. See how this light blue one is sitting underneath it and that they don't mesh? This is something that's just going parallel to the piece we are looking for. So let's deselect that and go a little bit further. Okay, so let's try this piece right here. Alright, so this looks a little bit better. See how that actually fits in to the dark blue piece instead of going underneath it? That's what we're looking for. So let's continue following this one. Alright, and it's hit the edge. Let's make sure it just disappears. Oops. Not that one. Okay, so it looks like it's gone. Let's go back now and trace the rest of this. Okay, so right here is going to be a very tricky little part. If I hit shift, you can see that there's a dark outline around this, but there's also another outline in here. So let's color this in and see what's going on. Okay, so we just added this piece right here. And to me, it looks like this big piece that I just added is actually just hitting the piece that we were working on and not actually a part of it. So I'm going to trace out the piece that I think is a part of it. So let's deselect this for a moment. Okay. So note that that is outside the inner line. So let's try tracing the rest of it a little bit. Okay. So I think that this piece that we just added is correct. And note how there's a little divot right here. This is where the piece that we had was. So let's put that back. And you can see how this piece on the left, just fits nicely into the divot. So I don't think that actually belongs. So we're going to deselect that. Control click in the 3D. And we're going to continue tracing this one. So that's an exceptionally challenging piece that happens once in a while. And what was happening is one piece of the neuron was gripping onto another one. And so it formed a little divot and it just sort of went around it. And what usually happens with those is sometimes you really can't tell just from the 2D and you're going to actually have to trace it out for a while. And then suddenly you'll see that in the 3D that what you're working on looks really, really weird. And you'll have to go back and find where that was. Alright, so it looks like that little branch hit the edge of the volume of the cube. So let's move back to the main part of the dark blue one now. Double click, just relocate us. Make it a little bit easier so we don't have to scroll back through everything. And now, We can continue tracing. All right, and once again, this has a bunch of stuff around the edges. Seems to be a cluster almost up here. I'm trying to make sure I don't forget the stuff down at the bottom, because it can be easy to miss that if you're working on a piece that goes across most of the cube. All right. We're going to zoom out a little bit in the 3D just to see how much we have left. And it looks like we're getting closer. Okay, so that little bit has disappeared. Let's continue over here. All right, and so it might look like this is a merger right here. See how this is outside the line, so you might think that's an error that the AI made. So that's a possibility, but if I look over in the 3D, I can see that it's actually a little branch coming out and then bending back around and touching the original piece. So that's what's going on there. And if we follow it out a little bit, we'll actually get to see it do that. So watch this. Okay, and see how that goes back around and touches that? So it's allowed to do that, that's a normal thing. It just can look like a merger if you're not quite expecting that. And that's why also the 3D is useful, because it kind of gave us a heads up to what was happening. All right, looks like everything has disappeared off the edge and that we're done with this challenging piece.